Hey friends, I'm back and today I have got quite a nice surprise in this box from Toman and Harley Benton. Coming right up. Yes, so I was really fortunate that again, Harley Benton and the guys at Toman have very kindly surprised me with not one, but two guitars in this box. So, without further ado, let's open the first one today. Let's get in. Okay, so here is number one, and I've absolutely no clue what it is any more than you do, because they haven't told me. So, let's find out what we've got from Harley Benton. I'll let you be the first to see it, as always. Okay. All right, I know what this is. And the fact that it comes with a push-in trim and several Allen keys and an Allen bar. This is very interesting. This is something I kind of wanted for some time. There's the checking sheet. There's a Rescue My Guitars in Case of Emergency sticker, which will definitely get stuck up somewhere in the studio here. And let's get this little beauty out. Okay. Now, I played this before, actually at Toman. And I was a tad worried and uncomfortable about it because when I was at TGU, there was a guy there whose guitar, this, is a very close replica of. So, it is, of course, from the Fusion range. And I'm going to say that this is the Harley Benton PT style guitar. And I think most of you will know what that means. Okay, one of the first things I did with this guitar was to record a brand new track with it. So let's go and hear it in a mix. There'll be lots more audio samples coming later of it on its own in isolation, but let's go and hear the track that I put together with this guitar. The other thing about this guitar is I had the incredible fortune to try the guitar that this is a close resemblance of and really enjoyed playing that. Now, we'll go and have a quick look at the specs on this guitar and take some closer looks via some pictures, and we'll come back and have a play.
This is the Harley Benton Fusion 2 HHEB-OCT. Construction is Sapele body with binding made of natural wood and a bolt-on Canadian hard rock maple neck. The fretboard is ebony with ivoroid fretboard inlays. The neck is a modern C profile with 22 medium jumbo stainless steel frets and a fretboard radius of 305mm. It has a Nubone nut and a Wilkinson 52K 2-point tremolo. The pickups are Roswell LAF-B CR Alnico 5 in the bridge and LAF-N CR Alnico 5 in the neck humbuckers. There's a three-way toggle switch, volume knob and tone knob, and a mini toggle that switches between single coil and humbucker. There's one master tone, one master volume. The chrome hardware includes a WCS staggered locking die-cast machine heads and a single roller string retainer. It comes sporting Daddario EXL 110s, 10 to 46 strings, and the colour that I got is ocean turquoise with a matching headstock.
Okay, so now you know all the specs on it. Just to have a quick look over the guitar to begin with, it's got a really nice finish on it. I'm not sure that I like this back plate going over the other cavity or really parallel to the other cavity, but considering that I always take these off, that won't matter at all. I love the new heel joint with the 4-point screws. That makes things quite easy when you want to, if you want to take the neck off for any reason. And this piece of wood on the back is really nice. And of course, the sparkly green finish on the front. Okay, at first glance, this is set up really nicely. The action is pretty much exactly how I like it, which is about a millimeter and a half to 2 mil at the 12th fret. The trem bridge is really nicely floating, and yep, everything seems to be nicely radiused. It's quite a flat radius neck. It's got the bone nut, of course, and most importantly, it's got the locking tuners. This one has come in tune. It's a nicely balanced guitar. It feels quite evenly balanced in the hand and on the lap, and particularly on the strap locks, or on the straps, which are shallow strap lock style buttons. So that's good. Very nice contour across the top here, which makes it quite nice for access. And for it to come in tune tells me one thing. Tells me that somebody at Thomann has had this out, checked it over, and given it a good setup. And it does feel very set up, very, very nicely ready to play. Perhaps they didn't think I could tune it. Thank you. The input jack, or the output jack, is in the bottom corner. It's not flattened off like I've seen on some of them, but actually I think that quite suits this style of guitar. All the controls seem really nicely easy flowing. Little bit scratchy on the volume pot, but the tone pot is certainly okay. All the switches are in good working order. And this is a feature that I love. The adjustment, the truss rod adjuster at the neck end, the neck pickup end of the fretboard, because it's very easy to get in and adjust those, whereas it's quite fiddly to get in between the strings when it's on the headstock. So yeah, really like that. A very nice looking fingerboard, very nice looking stainless steel frets, and nicely finished at the edges as well. As I say, this is clearly replicating a guitar made by a pretty high-end California builder for a good friend of mine, Pete Thorne. And as far as copies go, playing the real deal, I would say that the neck is a little bit thicker on the real deal. But actually, this is thick enough, and everybody knows that I like quite a thick neck. And it's pretty meaty and pretty nice to play, but would not preclude you from lots of nice lead work. Setup is good and the relief is good, but I do seem to have found some high frets at the top end of the neck here. I wonder what that's actually. Ah, okay. I haven't. What I've found is a bubble in the plastic covering the bridge pickup. So we'll take those bits of plastic off. I don't know how they set it up with that plastic on there, because I would have noticed that in the setup. Actually, the guitar has been brilliantly set up, and considering how easy those protective covers came off the pickup, I wonder if they took them off to set the guitar up and then put it back on again. At least it goes to show you that if I find something, I'm going to tell you. I thought there was some high frets at the top end there. The addition of a roller string tree is a really nice thought, and it gives a lot less friction. In combination with the bone nut and the Wilkinson trim, it should help to make sure that these last two strings, the B and the E string stay nice and low into the graded tuning pegs, and without going out of tune. So it's keeping that tension across the nut and still allowing plenty of free movement as well. So really great. I'm liking the raised logo on the Harley Benton here. This silver is actually proud of the headstock surface. And that's something I hadn't actually noticed before until getting my own. And yeah, it's quite a nice little feature. As always, let me have your thoughts on this guitar in the comments section down below. I love reading them and I try to respond to all of them if I can. And yeah, if you've enjoyed this, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, a like, and it can't hurt to subscribe. And if you do, don't forget to click that bell icon and then you'll be notified and let know every time I make an upload, which is usually every Tone Tuesday, Fretted Friday, and most streaming Sundays. I'll be back with the best content I can. But in the meantime, from me and from Harley Benton, you take good care.